Hey everybody, Canadian Operator here. It's nice to see all of you again, especially since it's been a while. For those of you who have been paying attention, I've been away for about 9 or 10 days. A big thanks to Max, one of my friends and of course subscriber of the channel, for allowing me to film this video today because he was the one who graciously provided this beautiful Chiappa 22 long rifle 1911. This is a really gorgeous firearm, and before anybody says anything, yes, we are completely empty, as you can see there. And there, and the magazine is also empty there. So we are in a nice safe environment, pointing the firearm in any of three safe directions, of course, just to show you how the firearm looks and talk about all of the different features. That being said, you didn't hear it incorrectly. This is a 22 long rifle. Of course, for those of you who are 1911 fans, much like myself, would know that in the early 1900s, when Colt came out with the original 1911, it was a 45 ACP. Of course, those are still very widely available, at least in the States they are. No pistols are really available freely these days in Canada because of our crazy bans that we've got going on. So here's hoping for a new conservative government, right? But in this case, I just wanted to kind of show you what this looks like in the hopes that maybe one day we will have more common sense laws with respect to firearms so that us, the responsible firearm owner, can enjoy these in peace at our local CFO approved range. That being said, we're going to be talking, as always, from the front to the back as Tito makes his way somewhere behind me. So if you see a cat somewhere, that's Tito. Say hello. And of course, I want to talk to you a little bit about some of the differences between this one and the other 1911 that Chiappa had available in the Canadian market before, of course, they were not available to anybody in Canada. And that was the custom model. So this one is what they call the compact. And then the other one was the custom. And it was pretty much identical with the exception that down here, right in front of that trigger guard, we had a nice little 1913 standard pick rail. And you could use that for mounting various things like lasers and flashlights and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and get started at the very front here. We'll go ahead and just decock this and we'll just place our magazine, which is again empty, back inside, just so I can kind of show you around. That fits in there really nicely. We'll talk about that in a little bit. So as you can see, we'll get a little bit closer there for you, and we have two sights, of course. Three sights, two in the back and one on the front. These are going to be your standard post sights. So this one's just going to be your middle, and then these are going to be your left and right on the back. And the idea is that, you know, when you're holding your firearm, you're basically looking through those two left and right sights, and you're lining up that middle sight right down the middle of those two other sights. And then what you want is you want this little post in the middle here to basically be just obscuring your paper target. And that is theoretically at least where your bullets are gonna go, if you're not me, because I'm a terrible shot. But that is a whole nother topic. Now, of course, this is going to look very, very similar, like almost any other 1911 out there. What's really cool is that we do have a 5-inch barrel in this, and that is the same with the custom model. So if you happen to have the custom model, or you want to borrow one from your friend, you can accept that those are basically going to be identical things there as far as the barrel is concerned. The slide and pretty much the frame of the firearm, according to Chiappa, is made of alloys, though it kind of feels like mild steel. It's got a very nice sort of matte black, sort of almost like anodized finish to it. It feels really nice and smooth. There's not really a whole lot of shininess to this, and I actually quite like that. Just matte black with some wood accents for the grips. Now again, according to Chiappa, these are going to be, I believe, walnut, although they do kind of feel a little plasticky, but it could just be the sound of sort of hardwood and the wood being, you know, obviously quite small, which the grips are. And then of course the actual grip itself here with the dovetail on the back, as you can see there, is very, very comfortable to hold. That dovetail also protecting the webbing of sort of between your index and your thumb from any kind of harassment from the slide as it moves back. Speaking of the slide, you can basically cock it very easily just like that. We've got a couple of grooves on this side and on this side here as well. So that makes it easy to cock. Now, of course, we do have the magazine in. We can push the mag release there, and that is going to come out. Now, of course, if you're not holding it like this, the mag will drop free. But then all you need to do is just pull back and let go, and that is going to make that come forward. Now, I'm just gonna go ahead and put this back in for a second. That goes in really nicely. And we'll bring this back again. That last round hold open is nice. The follower there from the magazine pushing up, holding the slide lock open. And then as you can see there, we've got our slide lock right there. So if you were to push that, that would come forward. So that's pretty cool. A lot of fun. Now, we don't have a sort of integral decocker on this. So, of course, this is an older pistol or older design. So we're not going to have a striker fire system like in more modern pistols. We do have our hammer on the back here. So the way we're going to decock this, very carefully, just going to rest our thumb right on the hammer there, pull the trigger, and then just gently guide that back down. And then again, I don't know if I showed you, but you've got your mag release right there. Now, that is... It's a bit of a pain to push in, but it's not too bad. So if you've got larger hands, you should be okay. One of the things that kind of are interesting is if we were to cock this again, you'll notice that we do have that slide release just right there. I'm not sure if you're able to see that well, but that is just really hard for me to reach. And I've got some pretty big hands. So something to keep in mind, if you want to borrow this or you want to pick this up at some point in the future, which hopefully will be an option for you, then just keep in mind that despite that this is a 22 long rifle pistol, you are going to have a little bit of trouble reaching around there to that little slide lock, but it can be done. As far as the trigger pull is concerned, we are looking at basically a single stage trigger here, and this is going to be a single action pistol as well. And so contrary to what you would have in a double action pistol where you are not cocked, as you can see there, we are not. And again, pointing in a safe direction, pull the trigger, nothing happens, right? Because this is a single action, not a double action. The benefit of that, other than, of course, you know, the detriment of having to cock it the first time, is that your trigger pull is going to be pretty light. In this case, it feels like about 5 or 6 pounds. If you wait until Tuesday when I start to film my range video, I take this thing out to the range and do my last sign off at the gun club, then I'll see if I can bring my meter with me so we can actually see what the trigger pull is like. But for now, if I were to make an educated guess, it kind of feels like about 5 or 6 pounds, which is really not too bad. So other than that, not a whole lot to say. That we do have some nice branding here on the front, a little Chiappa 1911-22. And of course, because this is a 22 long rifle, it is basically going to be super, super easy and affordable to shoot at about 10 cents a round, depending on what you're buying. Now, personally for me, I do prefer to shoot with cheaper ammunition just because the Blazer from CCI tends to work for me. It's a 40 grain lead round nose. And if you want to get an idea, sort of maybe some hints as to what you could try, depending on the cost, you can watch my video here where I do a comparison of various 22 long rifle ammos and kind of pick from that list. Now, again, that list is based on what's available to me, so it might not be the same in your area, but I've tried some LA, some CCI, some Norma, and a few other brands, and you'd be surprised who came out on top. So I personally shoot Blazer from CCI. This was very, very reliable, with the exception of one little problem I had, and that was with the firing pin. Of course, Max did let me know that this was an issue that he was having, where the geometry on the front of the firing pin was a little off, and it did cause some light primer strikes, and that was a little bit of a nuisance. But apparently, that is very easily rectified just by getting yourself a new firing pin, and then Bob's your uncle. So that being said, this is a very affordable firearm, and one thing that, of course, that I can't talk about is the price, because fellas, as you know, this is a wife-friendly channel. However, I can tell you that you get yourself one of these, if the law were to permit it, for about 100 to 150 bucks less than you could buy the stainless steel with black synthetic stock Ruger 10/22. By the way, did a video on that if you want to check it out. And that is a really, really good price for something as beautiful as this. It's a really, really nice finish. These wooden grips here do feel really nice as well. I love the little beaver tail on the back there. I enjoy that this is a single action. I love being able to cock that manually or simply just bring that slide back. Having that last hold open there, the last round hold open, is also quite nice. Again, we're nice and empty there. And yeah, it's just fantastic. So if I were able to recommend this for anybody that wanted to get their hands on a pistol, if they were able to, it would be a very easy recommendation. It's a lot of fun. It's not too light, although it does have some weight in terms of, you know, it doesn't feel cheap. It doesn't feel like a toy. It does feel like a really, really nice firearm. Now, the magazines are 10 rounds, of course, because that is the law in Canada. I'm sure that if you're in the US, you could probably get larger magazines for these, or probably even extended mags if you wanted to. But in Canada, we're looking at 10 rounds. That's more than enough. My buddy Max here's got about four different magazines, so you've got those loaded. You've got 40 rounds good to go. So that being said, I hope you found this video helpful and enjoyable. If you did, it really does help the channel. If you become a subscriber, if you've not done that already, with notifications turned on, do come by our Discord again. That's going to be down in the description. And if you'd like to find another way to support my channel and help me to continue to do what I'm doing, we do have an Etsy store. Again, a link for that will be down below. If there's stuff you want to see, let me know. I can do custom orders for you as well. And then, of course, we do also have the super thanks under the video because we are now YouTube partners, which is absolutely awesome. And we will have some memberships coming soon. Of course, you can always use the various Amazon affiliate links in some of my other videos if you just want to browse around and pick something up anyway. Won't cost you anything extra, but it really does help the channel. Thank you so, so very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next one. And until then, happy shooting.